In today's video, I am flying to sunny Los Angeles to have my dream come true. I am embarking on an adventure that will not only satisfy the crazy fangirl in me, but I am also about to uncover one of the biggest mysteries about the VR fitness industry. Yesterday, I got down to beautiful, sunny Los Angeles. This weekend, my favorite fitness brand, Les Mills, is doing one of their live recordings for the next 3 days. There is going to be tons of live classes of my favorite group exercise programs ever. There is going to be a reveal of a new Les Mills class. I cannot wait. All right, let's get to it. Let's get some food and coffee, because apparently downtown LA likes to drill in the sewer system until 3 a.m, which is great, I don't need much sleep when I'm going to a big fitness event, you know? That's fine. Why do I care more about a Les Mills VR app than other VR fitness apps? Les Mills began in 1968 in Auckland, New Zealand, and is still ran by the Les Mills family. With over 130,000 instructors and partnering with over 20,000 clubs worldwide, the science and evidence-based classes offered by Les Mills engage millions of people every single day. I have personally been a Les Mills participant and fan for over 23 years, and seeing them enter the VR market has made me intrigued.
I just walked the wrong way for 10 minutes, so now I'm in a bit of a rush, but hopefully I can make it there for the first class. I'm not stressed.
Fortunately, I made it to the convention center with at least a few seconds to spare. I was greeted by members of the Otters team, who got me all set up and gave me a quick tour of the Les Mills Live Athlete Village. If you are wondering who Otters Lab is, they are the developers behind VR favorites like O-Shape and Body Combat VR. I was so excited to see that Les Mills, Otters Lab, and Meta had teamed up to dedicate a large part of the Athletes Village to showcasing the VR adaptation of one of Les Mills' most popular programs. Although I could have stayed in the comfort of the Quest 2 and VR workout, it was time for the first class of the weekend.
Okay, so just in the first class, Les Mills cardio, great, it's insane, it's intense, it's everything that I love it for. So much fun being back into group class with a lot of people, feeling that energy, and I can't wait for the rest of the class.
Les Mills classes have always had the ability to hypnotize me and pull me in, and although I would have loved to participate in every single class this weekend, I decided to save my body and sit in on a few. While watching the filming of Body Attack and absorbing the energy of the room, I kept wondering why. Why did a fitness giant like Les Mills decide to take the big leap from live in-person workouts and gamble on VR? I knew I had to find out by the end of the weekend, as it was time to let loose. The final class of the day did not disappoint, and while high on the fumes of dance, endorphins, sweat, and joy, I completely forgot to say goodnight to the camera. You'll just have to believe me when I say it was magical. All right, day two, here we go. Thanks to the incredibly helpful Otter Labs team, I started my day by meeting two of my biggest heroes, Body Combat Program Directors Rachel Newsham and Dan Cohen. And after I was done giggling and grinning from ear to ear, I even managed to ask them a couple of questions.
We started talking about it about 15 years ago.
And it was a funny conversation because even back then, what about like a gamification version of what we do in real life? You could do like an arrow and you've got to hit an arrow.
We were just waiting for the right device and access so that people could globally access it. Otters Lab have all the experience technically.
Yep.
We had all the experience in the fitness industry. So the collaboration of this was too great coming together.
I tried really hard not to keep Dan and Rach for too long, and as much as I would have loved to talk to them all day, I knew they had a full schedule, and I had to get to the next class, Les Mills' most popular program, Body Pump. And it's lunchtime! When we got back to the Athletes Village, I was excited to see both Dan and Rach hanging out by the Meta VR stand. It is definitely clear that these two care a lot about the VR adaptation of Body Combat, and that this is something they have considered for a long time. However, I still didn't have a good answer as to why Les Mills, as a company, decided to expand beyond proven engagement methods like live classes and mobile apps and enter the unproven territory of VR fitness. My question will have to remain unanswered for a little bit longer, as I managed to snag the time of two very special people.
General question about the new program that's being revealed tonight. Is official title Les Mills Dance?
Yes. Okay. Official title is Les Mills Dance. First release. We're very excited. We know at Les Mills and all of our clubs around the world that dance is a huge category. Mm-hmm. And so we just wanted to try something brand new. It's a really authentic class. We're not changing it for group fitness. We're not changing it for high cardio.
Each track is like kind of has its own world, its own identity in music and in movements. Just walk in, pull your walls down, and just have lots of fun.
Stand in the front row, put a huge smile on your face, and then when you feel that joy, when you feel that ecstasy, let it come out.
To with the reveal of the new Les Mills Dance, which was so much fun. I absolutely loved it. I'm drenched sweat and have the biggest smile. It is a little bit late. Actually, it's not too bad. It's like 7 o'clock today. So not the worst, but I am gonna head back to the hotel, just have another shower, get some food and sleep, because tomorrow we gotta be back here at 8 a.m. We're gonna finish with the reason we're here, Body Combat, tomorrow night. Before the after party. Apparently there's an after party. I didn't bring anything to wear. It's gonna be okay. We'll figure it out. I might still have some clean stuff. For now, have a good night. See you tomorrow. So I'm running a little late again, but it's okay. I got coffee. I made it and the party is already going. All right, let's get to the VIP room and find our place in this classroom.
Just finished body balance this morning. I just turned on the music, which was a little sad because I was so relaxed and just comfortable here on the mat. What an absolutely incredible, incredible, incredible release.
As I left the comfort of the yoga mat and found new comfort in these amazing massage boots, my mind kept wandering back to the question I have been asking myself for the past 18 months. Why VR? I had an incredibly enlightening conversation with Dan and Rachel yesterday, and I now understand why the decision was so easy for them to make. But Les Mills is so much more than just body combat. With millions of fans worldwide, what about VR made them want to take a leap and risk losing credibility with fans still considering VR a gaming platform and VR fitness for an inferior workout? With time running out, I knew I only had a few chances left to get my answer. It was time to head for the top.
You can introduce yourself, maybe.
Okay, awesome. So, hi everyone. I am Jaime from Honest Lab. Initially the first experience that we had was with O-Shape in the rhythm space. And then we started seeing lots of reviews, especially during the pandemic, of, hey, O-Shape is our go-to for cardio, actually. And then we were like, huh, we actually should get something going into fitness. So we were lacking the fitness expertise. We knew how to cater for a VR audience, but we didn't know how to cater for fitness. And that's why we started knocking on doors. And the first one that we did was the biggest one and the one that we really wanted.
Start on the top, right? Yeah.
We can hear the excitement. So we did call Les Mills, and after 6 months, a baby was conceived.
Amazing!
As I was wrapping up my chat with Jaime, we were informed that the moment we had been waiting for all weekend was finally here. I barely had time to put away my camera as we were being ushered into the arena. It was finally time for the program that made all of this possible, Body Combat. As we were wrapping up the weekend, I knew I still hadn't reached the end of my big quest. So, remember this guy? The mysterious man who ushered us to the body combat recording? That was James Graham, Chief Strategy and Business Affairs Officer for Les Mills. Although I wasn't able to sit down with him during the weekend, he promptly replied to my email later on, answering my big question of why Les Mills decided to incorporate VR into their offering. Graham referred to the Les Mills mission to create a fitter planet. He stated that VR allows them to reach a new audience, sharing my passion for engaging people who are not reached by traditional fitness offerings. More interesting is Les Mills finding that the current fitness trends are centered around flexibility and engaging experiences. Virtual reality incorporates both of these elements to enhance the workout experience while also providing a great opportunity for a future fitness ecosystem that is yet to be truly explored. Hearing that a fitness giant like Les Mills considered VR to have such a huge potential and their excitement for exploring and shaping the future is incredibly important for the VR fitness industry. This trip to LA was one of a lifetime, and my mind hasn't officially landed yet. I learned so much more about the future of Les Mills and VR than what I could fit into this video, and I will share this with you in the coming time. For now, if you want to dive deeper into the world of Body Combat VR and why it was awarded Best Quest App in 2022, check out this video right here.